We're talking about Trent Bridge, 2007. Yeah, there you go. We've got a few pictures for you as well. It happened in the end of July. And as we know, Zach got 9 wickets in that game. Bowled India to victory.
Did you get me out?
He also dismissed Michael in that after he got a century. So both of you did really well.
You got me out.
Second time I got lucky. Yeah, second time I got lucky. First innings was perfect.
Pad.
Yeah.
That's right, yeah, around the wicket, new ball, and it flicked the under edge of my thigh pad and went back onto my stumps.
There you go. You both looked slightly younger than right now.
Yeah, there
still looking good, but there you go. That's the wicket. We've got some images from there. That's Zach, and the last one, definitely my favorite. This one's my favorite. What are you saying to Michael, Zach? Come on. What are you saying to him? There's something going on there.
That was a fiery game. It was. Yeah. It got a little bit heated, didn't it?
Yeah.
And what did we make you chase?
There was a beamer being bowled in that innings.
Yeah, around the wicket beam.
Yeah,
it was a rather large no ball as well, if I remember. Srisan just managed to step over the line just a little bit.
It was crazy.
I think it was to Paul Collingwood.
KP.
KP? Oh, yeah. Fair enough then. Fair enough. I understand that.
But that was Zach, you obviously don't remember what you said to him, but it looked like it was something interesting.
Well, I seriously don't remember.
No, he was always very aggressive on the pitch. He was a lot more aggressive than he is now. He's a lovely gentleman there.
Yeah,
he was rather, what do you call it? In your face. In your face fast bowler. He swung round trees though, didn't he, at Trent Bridge?
I actually never used to sledge a lot.
Yeah.
I used to say things, but I would never... Yeah.
State facts.
It was a stare.
Yeah.
Like, you don't know how to
talk something about technique.
Yeah.
Talk something about the captaincy issues. I think they had different captain for Test and One Days that time.
Yeah, I think he was reminding me of that.
That was a fiery game indeed, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was a fiery game.
Yeah, I think it was only 80 required to win.
Yeah.
You got your four down.
It was getting close. It was getting close in that second
round. We needed about 180 to make it interesting. We got, but you skilled us in the first innings, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you blew us away. We didn't get anything in the first innings. Were we made to follow on?
No.
So we batted first and you got a big
score. You batted first.
And then we were getting closer to getting a big lead. And then
we lost two or three wickets as well.
He did for us. He kept on getting the ball swinging
but
too late.
Second new ball did the trick. It was getting tricky, I think. You know,
you got him after tee.
One more session there. And,
you got him 124, you got him after tee.
Yeah, so, I think we collapsed after that, didn't we? Didn't we go pretty quickly?
Probably not a good cup of tea then.
No, it was just a little bit milky.
Yeah, it's no good. No. It's got to be green or black. That's how you got to keep it. Milk's for calves, not for humans.